when you come to the realm of light, you begin to interact with different installations there, with different operations. That's why all of us read the Bible, but our calling comes from intimacy, because that was how it was instituted. He said to the man, dress the garden, keep it. He said to Abraham, get thee out of thy country, out of thy kindred, out of thy father's house, to the land that I will show you. He said to Moses, get thee to Egypt and raise for me a people that they may worship me in the wilderness. It has nothing to do with what you read. What you read is a migration to the place where you hear his voice. That's why I say, if you don't journey, you won't be relevant. You can become popular, you can become influential. It doesn't mean you are relevant, because when they check the integrity of your work, is the degree to which it dispels darkness, not the degree to which men clap. Somebody told me, you have many followers. One looked at my page and said, ah, oh boy, this is your page. Then they put fertilizer on top. Why they grow like this? I said, don't be moved. That's number. They are not human beings. They are not human beings. Don't be moved. Because those same figures there, they are on many other places. It's not human beings. That's number. If you want to check what is happening, go and check in the spirit and find out the havoc you are doing to darkness. If it is true that you have entered the realm of light, you begin to interact with the installations of heaven. And I will show you some of them. One of the installations of Zion that you begin to interact with is the altar of the coals of fire. Fire is not running in church. Fire is not shouting when you're on the microphone. You know, this kind of fire, you don't see it with the naked eye. It's not visible. It's an intrinsic, organic operation within the heart of a man. See, let me explain what I mean. In hell, which is the lowest realm of spiritual existence, fire torments. So the operation of fire in Hades is to create torment. On earth, the operation of fire is different from the operation of fire in Hades. The operation of fire on earth is to burn and to consume. But if you go higher to the realm of God, fire doesn't torment. Fire doesn't burn. Fire purifies. That's why I told you, every installation in the spirit has a purpose. So when a man begins to travel vertically, purification is natural to him. The reason is because he is interacting with an economy in that realm called fire. So Isaiah was a popular prophet. He was traveling horizontally all his ministry until a point came. He said, let me try what this upward ladder looks like. I have moved around the whole of Israel. Everybody knows me as a prophet. What happens if I travel vertically for a second? You know, he was popular among men, but in the spirit he was not popular. Everybody knew him as a prophet. That's on earth. When he came to the spirit, nobody introduced him. He introduced himself. And the way the man introduced himself was strange. The title of a prophet was not attached once. He said, I am a man of unclean lips. He said, woe unto me. That's a popular prophet on earth. That's why I told you, horizontal journey is a risk if there is no backing of the vertical journey. The day the guy began to travel vertically, he discovered everything he was doing horizontally was a cost from the realm of God. He said, I'm a man of unclean lips. Woe unto me. But because he has journeyed upward, there was an economy that was activated. It was the economy of the coals of fire. And he said one of the angels took one of the coals from the fire and touched his tongue, and his tongue was healed instantly. When a man begins to travel vertically, he will notice that many addictions will die on their own. Every day young people call you, they say, I'm masturbating, I'm fornicating. Don't waste your time praying for them. You know why? If you pray for them, you have set them up. Because when an evil spirit is gone out of a man, he moves about in dry places. If he doesn't find where to stay, it will return to where it was cast from. If it is kept and garnished but empty, the spirit will not enter. The spirit knows if he enters, the power that cast it out will cast it again. So the spirit will go and invite seven more wicked demons. That means there are some demons in the buffet that don't have a habitat. If you know how many demons are waiting for accommodation who don't have yet, you will treasure your purity. Because one third of the angels fell, and there are over 100 trillion angels. If you know how many demons can be assigned to one man, you will walk with God closely. In the allocation of the demonic, there are some that don't even have allocation in your life, because your morning is occupied, afternoon is occupied, evening is occupied. So some of the demons go to tell the principalities, please assign us in his dream. Even if we don't possess him, when he's sleeping, let's just enter his dream, at least have accommodation for the night. So in the daytime, the guy is fornicating, he's lying, he's doing all kinds of things. Even when he's sleeping, he's still fornicating. When an evil spirit is gone out of a man, it will return with seven more wicked demons. So when somebody says masturbating and you cast out the demon and you don't teach the person how to become occupied, the next time he will not only masturbate, he will rape. So when people tell me they are masturbating, I tell them the reason is because where you are operating from, the demons of masturbation also have accommodation there. There's a place where there's no accommodation for the demon of masturbation. So come up hither. You are living where demons live. That's why they have accommodation in your life. Come up hither. And somebody is pastoring a church where there are many fornicators, and he said, we don't need revival. We are born again. Come up hither.